everybody, I'm Dylan Black. Welcome to another edition of Daytime Ottawa on Rogers TV. And we have a busy show here. Let's kick it off with a bang. We'll have a musical performance by this young man who is, he's got the blues in his heart in a big way. Let's say hello first off to Todd Bernard with Calabogie Blues and Ribfest. How are you, Todd?
Good, thank you, Dylan.
Good to see you. And as well, we've got Lyle Odjick with us.
Yes,
how are you, Lyle?
Not bad, how about
Wonderful
you?
To see you. You were involved in this Calabogie Blues and Ribfest. Pretty exciting.
Yeah, it's exciting stuff. I'm very stoked for the weekend to come.
Yeah, we're going to hear a performance from you live coming up in moments. But Todd, tell us about this this amazing Blues and Ribfest. It hasn't been around too long. How many years are we celebrating here?
So this will be our 7th edition. We started in 2011. Mm-hmm. Started off as a small festival. It's up in Calabogie, beautiful area of the Ottawa Valley, Calabogie Peaks Resort.
Yeah.
So it's a great venue, natural amphitheater, beautiful setting. Started there sort of in earnest in 2011, and the festival's just kind of grown step by step by step over mm-hmm. the years, and version 7 this year.
How far away is Calabogie from Ottawa?
Depending, east-west, between 45 minutes and an hour.
Yeah, beautiful scenic drive.
It is, from Ottawa Valley, yeah, for sure.
Tell us about some of the musical. Obviously, you have Lyle on board, but we've got all kinds of superstars. Where do you want to start?
Well, I start by saying it's a true blues festival. We've been pure to that since the first one. And again, this year we think we've done a good job with the lineup. On Friday, we've got Blues and Company, which is a local Ottawa band that recently won the Ottawa Blues Society's Road to Memphis mm-hmm. Band Competition. So we've got sort of an agreement with the Ottawa Blues Society each year. The winner of that competition kicks off our festival. So they start things on Friday. Then I've got Carson Downey coming in from Nova Scotia, a great three-piece act. The Friday night headliner is a lights-out good American piano player mm-hmm. Called Victor Wainwright. He won the 2016 B.B. King Entertainer of the Year Award. So that will get things off to a great start. And then on Friday, then on Saturday, the lineup is really good too. Big Sugar is our headliner. Really looking forward to seeing Gordy and the band opening up for Big Sugar. Their support is Tom Lavin and the legendary Powder Blues. So
that's not bad.
National blues journeyman in Canada. So it's a real good lineup. We're excited.
And you still have into Sunday as well. You've got performances.
Yeah, programming as well on Sunday. I should have mentioned Lyle kicks off our Saturday programming at noon. Mm-hmm. Then on Sunday, we've got a couple of great Aboriginal performers coming in from the Six Nations Reserve in southwestern Ontario. Mm-hmm. And headlined by a Maple Blues Award winner, Harp Dog Brown, with a special guest, Sugar Brown. So great way to cap it off.
And the Aboriginal content of this year is very important to you as well.
Yeah, we've been trying to grow that sort of year over year. We've learned, being immersed in the blues community for some time now, that Canada has got a ton of great Aboriginal blues artists. So a couple of years ago, we had one Aboriginal act, and then we went to two, and this year we've got, three Aboriginal acts. So Lyle playing on Saturday, and we've got a couple on Sunday. So mm-hmm. again, just to showcase the great Aboriginal talent we've got in Canada.
And Lyle, you're from a local reserve, Maniwaki.
Yeah, Kitigan ZB, right next to Maniwaki, Quebec.
Okay, all right. So like you mentioned offset of this interview, that it's very important for you to be part of this and have Aboriginal content as well.
Yeah, I figure Aboriginal people have a good place to represent the blues, since we've been through a lot of struggles in our own country, so similar to where the blues kind of originated down in the States, same
Wonderful.
Kind of struggles.
We're going to hear a song from you in about a minute from now, but Todd, tell us about two things, the ribs mm-hmm. and the family friendly zones as well.
Sure, so it is a blues and rib festival, so every year we've got professional ribber teams there. They start smoking on Thursday when they show up. They fire up the smokers and they run the smokers right through the weekend until we wrap things up on Sunday. So for anyone out there who likes their barbecue, we've got lots of that. It's all fantastic. They do chicken and pulled pork and the ribs, of course, as well. That essentially, kicks things off on Friday. The gates open at 4 o'clock. So come on up,
bring the family.
Get your food on. Yeah, it's a beautiful setting. There's a beach nearby if you want to take a break with the kiddies and go have a swim on at Calabogie Peaks Resort's beach. It's a beautiful setting. It is a family friendly environment. Lots of kids there. I've been bringing my kids there since day one.
CalabogieBlues.com to get your tickets and for more information, of course. And Lyle, what's the name of the song we're going to hear?
Dust My Broom.
Dust My Broom. We'll recognize that one. Calabogie Blues and Ribfest happening this weekend. Calabogie Peaks Resort, Todd Bernard and Lyle Odjick. Let's have that song.
All right, some Dust My Broom coming at you. With the best girl I've been loving, well, my friends can have my room. I wanna write me a letter to telephone every town I know. Gonna write me a letter to telephone every town I know. Well, my baby not a man to walk it. Maybe she's in Ottawa, I hope. My time ain't long. Well, I wanna queer my baby, breaking up my happy home.